EVE Online Anywhere is now available for the Alpha tier. And of course, it's always been available for the Omega tier. But what does this really mean? And how does it stack up against GeForce NOW? You're probably going to be quite hard pressed to see the difference in the browser there. So what is EVE Anywhere? Well, if you are an EVE Online player, you can now buy some Omega time to use EVE Anywhere in your browser. This means that you can play EVE Online anywhere with a supported browser and in the supported countries. Although these supported countries aren't publicized right now, you can find out quite quickly just by going to the EVE Online site and seeing if you have the Launch in Browser button. Now, if you are a keen EVE Online player, you will most likely already be subscribed to the Omega tier, which means that this is free for you to play. And as you can see, actually in the browser, it is capped at 1080p and high settings, but it does actually look and play very well. When you first launch it, it is a bit pixelated after the initial stream test runs and it stabilizes. You can see just how clear and clean this is. No input latency at all using mouse and keyboard, and that is recommended for EVE Online in general. And you can see from the quality of the station here and the trails, as well as the stars in the background, that compression was really not an issue. Occasional bit of pixelation during the hyper travels, but really not that noticeable. So how does this stack up against GeForce NOW in the browser? Obviously, you can still play that for free with EVE Online or with the priority tier for those extended sessions. And this is where it was a bit surprising. At 1080p, the quality difference really isn't that big here, if noticeable at all. I'll have to excuse the flickering. I'm not quite sure what happened to my recording. This did not happen in game. It was extremely smooth and clear. But as you can see from the quality here in between those flickers, everything looked and performed perfectly well. It was very slightly sharper than the EVE Anywhere browser implementation from Intel, but there really wasn't much in it. And if you are just going to be playing in the browser at 1080p, you're really not going to notice much of a difference. As you can see here, once I put them side by side, coming up to the warp gate, it's very difficult to tell which one is which. GeForce NOW is actually the one on the left. So it does look like there are a few more stars, but this could just be generally this system and a few more effects around the warp gate. However, GeForce NOW still has its ace up its sleeve. If we switch to the RTX 3080 tier on a PC, obviously we can now have up to 4K, but looking at the 1440p implementation here on that 3080 tier, it just looks absolutely stunning. Look at all the effects there, especially with that explosion. And if I look at this mining platform here on these asteroids, it just looks absolutely stunning. So GeForce NOW still has the trump cards of being able to play the 2K or 4K on PC and show TV. But in the browser, it's pretty close to the EVE Anywhere implementation. And it'll be very interesting to see if other games start going this route of having their own implementation as white labels. Let us know what you think of the quality of EVE Anywhere using the Intel implementation in the browser versus GeForce NOW. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all things cloud gaming. And we will see you next time.